All right, so we're gonna now enter into a discussion about the spinal cord. Spinal cord begins at the foramen magnum, so this is the occipital bone, and this piece of metal would represent the brain stem, and then when it gets to the foramen magnum, it's going to become the spinal cord. And the spinal cord runs from the foramen magnum to 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, those are lumbar, somewhere around here, L1, L2, that's where the spinal cord ends. And it ends in a little cone, pointed shape called the conus medullaris. Can't see it here, but that's where it ends. And then the nerves hang off of the conus and continue downward all the way to the coccyx. A couple of other things on here to point out. Spinal cord's embedded within the bone, protected by the lamina and the vertebral body. All of these yellow things here on the left side and on the right side, these are what we refer to as spinal nerves, all right? And there's a spinal nerve for each level, vertebral level, sacral level, coccygeal level of the spine. The trick is the numbering. There are 7 cervical vertebrae, 12 thoracic, 5 lumbar. The sacrum originated from 5 vertebrae that fused, so we say 5 segments, and then 1 coccyx. So they're numbered based on those segments, with one exception, and that would be here in the cervical area. Coccyx, there's 1 coccyx, there's 1 pair of spinal nerves. Sacrum was 5 segments, there are 5 pairs of sacral nerves. Lumbar, 5 lumbar vertebrae, 5 pairs of lumbar nerves. 12 thoracic, 12 pairs of thoracic nerves. 7 cervical vertebrae, 8 pairs. And that's where the exception is, 8 pairs. And the reason is right here, okay? This is cervical 1 atlas, and this is the occiput. The first pair is between occipital bone and C1. It begins above C1. So there are 7 vertebrae, and below each vertebrae are 7 nerves, plus the one above. So the first one, what we would call C1 spinal nerve, is above atlas. And then C2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, T1 through 12, L1 through 5. What else do we see? You remember the bodies, you remember the intervertebral discs, you remember the holes. The holes are the intervertebral foramen, and now you see that the hole is the exit for the spinal nerve, the entrance or the exit for the spinal nerve.